Hi, buddy. Okay, so make him an asshole. Hi, everybody. Hi, everybody. And you now. Hi, everybody. I'm Kirsty Meekin from Nao Nails. In this video, we are going to do a Christmas lantern nail. Did I say it right?
You did this time.
Did I?
What did you say before?
She kept saying lantern.
Lantern.
Lantern. It's yeah. Lantern.
Instead of lantern.
Lantern.
I don't
even
know where
I've
got that from.
I don't know where I've got it from.
But it's a lantern.
It's a lantern and it's going to be nice and glowy and all ooh, beautiful. Ready for the winter nights. Let me just clean that nail up with a bit of gel residue wipe-off solution. We've already removed surface shine, removed a nail actually, a nail extension. So we're going to use a tip today. We're going to do like a tip and overlay. We're going to keep it quite simple and nude. Then the design is going to go on top of that nude nail. Meaning we can change the design on these loops. Let's trim down the length. Oh, look, everything's connected together with magnets. So it's a new Christmas decoration for the nail technician's tree. So I'm just going to buff this, give it a little bit of a file and just sort of blend it a little bit. It doesn't need overly blending. Give it a little bit of a pinch, make it super narrow, like that. Just give that a wipe over with gel residue wipe-off solution. Then we are ready to prep with our prep system. So Nao Nails do a dehydrator and then they also do the primers. I'm going to use the Ultra Bond acid primer today. So I'm going to use natural beige because I just want this kind of nude nail. So I'm going to pick up a bead. I'm using medium speed liquid from the acrylic system that Nao Nails do, and I'm just going to tease this to the end of the nail. Always starting with the length of the nail because it's further away from body heat, so it'll take longer to set. So then we put the bead at the cuticle area, drag that down, creating the apex and the strength in the nail. We're gonna let that set before we file. Okay, I'm reloaded. I've put my hair up because I'm sweating like I won't believe. We are rolling, aren't we?
Yeah, we're rolling.
I'm so hot today, even though it's winter outside, it's bloody boiling in here. So I've filed the nail, as you can see. Might have forgot to film that bit, but you've all seen me file a million times, I'm sure, and we have actually got videos just about filing, so yeah, have a little look at them.
I think Fear's filing routine went out yesterday.
Oh, see?
Yeah, just filing.
Just filing, just break it down.
Does she have her own specific routine as well?
Because she's got such big long nails, it's like, it's a good routine to demonstrate. Yeah, she's a good model to demonstrate it on, so we can see all the angles. Yes, it's so long. I'm going to use the Indecisive Thermochromic.
Named after you.
But you know what? I'm a Libra. I am indecisive all the time. This is going to be our background colour. I'm going to do two coats of this.
But doesn't the Thermochromic do something strange?
It does, it's very, I mean, it's a strange thing, it's a strange being. It changes colour. Well, it didn't change colour,
colour
disappears. Ooh!
So that's confusing me as to why you're using it as a background, because it's just going to disappear. Nope. See how it's disappeared? It just disappeared because of the heat from our thumb.
Yeah, so the heat from the finger will make it disappear.
So how do you know when you finished?
I don't. I don't.
You're just going to be painting forever.
I thought my nail was tall.
No, we've done that video before.
Couple of coats there. Pop it in the lamp. Come on, duck. So, I want to use this because I just think it'll be like a day and night kind of effect. That's the plan in the brain. Visualising the design in my brain. And I think visualising a design is so important when you're doing any kind of artistic work. That was my posh voice. Yeah, darling. Luke, oh my God! Where's he gone? Vanished!
Yeah, you definitely need to do several coats of that one.
Oh, it's terrible. He just keeps vanishing. Obviously disappearing because of the heat of the lamp and the heat of Vanessa's finger. What I want to do first of all is I want to get a little bit of black. So serious black. And I want to mix it with a little bit of the Urban Graffiti top coat. And this is going to be my little sketch colour. So imagine I'm sketching it out with a pencil. This is what I'm going to do. So as I was thinking then, I thought, I really need to sketch this out just to get a composition right. So I thought, I want to do it in gel. And I just thought, yeah, I need to do this. It's all about visualising and planning. You see how it's light and coloured? Just want to sketch it first, just so I get everything right. Do that for me, that little sketch. Right, so we've got our little sketch. It's just a rough sketch, but I needed that so I can do my little glow. So I've got two fluorescent colours. I have Atomic Tangerine. And then I've got, what's this one called, Adam?
I think it's called Hazardous. Another one named after you.
Yeah. I'm going to use a little bit. This isn't glow in the dark, this oops, but it is a nice red. I think it will just, we might just need a little touch of it. And we'll need a little bit of white. Look how it's getting cold at the tip. Getting blue. Right, okay. So, we're going to create this glow. So I now know that this part of the lantern is going to need colour. And I want it to glow slightly outside of the lantern as well. So I'm just going to put some of that on there with a little bit of top coat, because I'm going to use a little bit of top coat and sort of dilute the edge of that glow there. See how it just softens it? And same here. I'm going to do it really nice. Just adding that little bit of top coat will just sort of soften that glow as it mixes. Okay, pop that in the lamp. Then we want a bit of orange. A little bit of top coat again, just to soften. Then I'm going to take the red, and I'm just going to pull through to create a bit of flame. Pop that in the lamp. Now we're just going to use the serious black, and we're actually going to do the lantern for real this time. So I'm going to outline first. I'm going to fill in that bottom part because that needs to be black. And just add a little bit there as well. I'm making it up a little long, to be honest, with this shape of the lantern. Put me that in the lamp. These lanterns kind of remind me of Mary Poppins.
Mary Poppins?
Mary Poppins! Now I'm gonna do like a decorative pole that it'll be on in the street. You see what I mean about Mary Poppins? Mm. Have you watched Mary Poppins?
Yeah.
Can't you remember the old-fashioned lanterns?
Well, of course, yeah.
Lantern.
It doesn't remind me of it, though.
Oh, it reminds me.
My aunt's street had really old street lights in. In like the keeled over and stuff.
Yeah.
And instead of replacing them fully, they'd put like modern versions in. So it was quite cool.
Top that in the lamp. Right, I'm just going to top coat this. Just to seal it. Pop me that in the lamp. Then we're going to use a little bit of foil glue. So I'm going to pop that onto the backing paper from the sculpting form because I need to use the brush. While that hand's in the lamp, I'm going to get my foil ready as well. I'm going to wipe the back of the foil with gel residue wipe off solution. Make it nice and clean. Let that dry. Get the foil glue on a brush. Put me that in a lamp. Right, so we're gonna get the foil now and press. And that'll just come off where we put the transfer foil. I like it, I like it. Yeah. Very nice. Let's top coat it. Into the lamp, please. So we got daytime. Oh, we got nighttime! Oh my god! Oh, I love it. That is so cool. Sun's rising, yeah? It's rising. Look at the sun. Rising. And also, the flame will glow in the dark. There you are. Day and night lantern. Lantern.
Oh my god. Lantern.
Lantern.
Yes.
Lantern. Lantern. It's a glow in the dark.
God. Doesn't sound like
day
a
to
word
night.
Anymore.
Lantern. Thingy me bob. I hope you've enjoyed it. Everything I've used today will be listed below. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye. and the design was good.
Not today.
Not today.